Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino, yeah. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Eno. Think I'm part Italian, blame it on Gino. Smells like the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Put a genie with the snails in a five-star hotel. And I wish he's well when they wish for me to fail. I might donate petty bills, they can't get it by theyself.
That's why you treat women good, but not too good. I give them too much, then they don't need me.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. I'ma get it either way. I don't even gotta say what I want, when I want. They just put it on my plate. I could get it right away. Take you through my day to day. Wake and pray, make that play. Get some good at my place. There's some on the way. Cause my bro's on the way. I got stones on my gold. I got loads in my safe. Had a 7-figure summer, so I'm putting on some weight. Set up getting thick, so I put it on display. Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
In the pocket, no change. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay, all my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay, so when I die, I ain't gon' be from old age. Somebody gon' want revenge, somebody might want it now. Right pocket got euros, left pocket got pow, pow. Somebody gon' want revenge, somebody might want it now. Throw the ball with the right hand, catch with the left, touchdown. Step back, let me get some room. Congrats every time I'm through. Same pack and nobody new, so I never get confused. Hotel, get a bird's eye view. Hotel, get a waiting room. Read a magazine while you wait for me. Baby, I'll be gone so soon. Phone gotta be off, each store got locks. I got some trusted shoes. Okay. 10K on the countertop, don't look so shocked, it's nothing new. Okay. Death comes in threes. Three. Wins come in twos. Two. Cash comes in ones. One. Throw it up, celebrate some news. Hey. I do a good job. Pull up and pop out and pull off. True. Hat on and hood on. Pedal to metal. Whenever.
We've had spotty showers since about 7 a.m. here in D.C., and the radar indicates it's going to continue. But nothing to stop football from happening at FedEx Field. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Washington Redskins. Strap in. This will be a good one. 2-1 loss teams getting together as they're underway on EA Sports. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The kind of tackling they want to see all game as he'll lose yardage to start things out. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
At the 17-yard line.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Play action. Now it's Allen. He's got his man on the crossing route. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Down, this is Geis. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with second and a yard. An excellent gain, 35 yards.
Things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us or their game plan, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, his second touchdown on the season. And the Redskins take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point attempt here still to come. We'll see if this rain affects the team's decisions going forward, but they kick it here, and it's good. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Jones, first carry for the USC man. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up near the 42. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. That, Charles, the first interception he's thrown here in year number two.
And I know it's just the first one, but didn't it feel like what we saw from him last year, where he was plagued by this type of a play? And they thought that, you know, over the offseason, going into a second season, some of that would go away. Thus far, still looks a lot like his rookie year.
Here's Allen. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. On the ground, it's Geis. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Geis showing he's going to be an important part of this Redskin backfield as he's in there again for first down.
Five wide.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. He goes full extension, and he's got it. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Redskin first down.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post-route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. Here's Allen on first and 10. Pass incomplete. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Now going to throw again, escaping the pressure right, and incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Allen to throw once more. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they'll throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Brings up second and 4 at the 26-yard line.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. This is Jones. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. He'll have a first down past the 40. And a cutback right sideline. And down right around the 37. That one's good for 35 yards on the ground and a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Now the former Terrapin. This is Ty Johnson. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. to throw on second down. Hayes, quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down. They have the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. After one, 7-0, Audie Sports. Before he's able to slip it inside the five-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Now Jones. And he's going to get this back to the three-yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man.
We got three. We got three, fellas. We got three. Get.
They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
So they need 6 yards here on third down. They're 2 for 2 on third down tries so far on this drive. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a 4th and goal. Let's think here. You're still just in the second quarter. You taking the 3 points?
I am taking the 3 points, and I'm just relying on my defense here. Show me you have a little confidence in them, and let the offense know, nice drive. Come back next time. We'll go get 6 then, but for now, we'll take the 3.
The kick by Elliott is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A good drive gets them inside the 5, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. To throw, it's Allen. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
On 3rd and long, it's Allen. And that will be incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on 3rd down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a 4th down decision.
And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And now that'll kick out of bounds, and this is going to be spotted back at their own 30. Oh, man. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Throwing again, Hayes. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. The Eagles on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10.
Check, 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 check. Get down, get down. Go, go. Go, go. Mike 56. Mike 56.
From the gun, Hayes. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
I know you're trying not to scoreboard watch, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
Yeah, need to do something to get more than that 3 number that they have on the scoreboard right now. Now a first down carry by Jones. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down. 2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join...
Who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
The coach.
All right, we get slap happy up here sometimes. Tackle made that time by Vita Vea.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Looking to throw on second down, Hayes.
Saw it in my eyes, it was the Tiger Hill. Gonna jump off the line and see the flight of field.
to show him skills. You ain't gotta tell me, I know I'm ill. Star is treacherous, I effortlessly show him skills.
I just ran a check up on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Dino. Think I'm part Italian, blending on Gino. Smells like the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Fed a genie with the snails in a five-star hotel. And I wish he's well when they wish for me to fail. I might donate petty bills, they can't get it by themselves.
That's why you treat my friend good, but not too good. I give him too much, then they don't need me.
Yeah, I just ran a check up on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. By myself, these I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself.
We've had spotty showers since about 7 a.m. here in D.C., and the radar indicates it's going to continue, but nothing to stop football from happening at FedEx Field. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Washington Redskins. Strap in, this will be a good one. Two one-loss teams getting together as they're underway on EA Sports. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Darius Geis, his first carry of the game. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
Allen looks to throw on third and 1. And he finds Safarian Jenkins. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. They'll run with Geis. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. The football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And here's Allen, throwing on third and long. Open man is Sims, he's got it. A big gain of 28 as the drive continues. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Ballard now looks to throw. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
Now they're coming up on play number 8 of this opening drive, but they're looking at a third and long. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. He's going to let this one go deep. And that'll be incomplete. Now, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. That's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet. But I'm not sure they're going to shy away from him. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. Now the first carry for Ronald Jones. And he'll be upended after a gain of 5, up to the 25-yard line.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Second and 5, rolling to his right. Caught by Jones. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
On third down, here's Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And he gets it away, and it's a laser headed for the sidelines. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And they had a long drive going last time, but it stalled out. But still, maybe something positive to carry forward from that last drive.
Well, a few different things that you carry forward. Number one, as you noted, they were moving it pretty well, so that gives them a lot of confidence. The second part is, keep your defense off the field. Gives them a chance to rest up a little bit. And last but not least, you've taken a good look at what you've done on offense, noted where the weaknesses are, and you know when you want to come back to them.
Like when you're organized with your points. Well done.
A, B, and C.
From the 22, Allen. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa able to record his fifth sack of the season. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. This will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Let's go, D. Big series right here. We got to step it up.
They'll run on first down. Jones. And he's able to carve out about six there, down to the 37.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
The last run got six, now second and four. From the shotgun, again to Jones. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard, stop short of the 35.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Gun on third down. Hayes. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. On first down, Jones. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top five, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A 6-yard pickup on the ground that time, and that'll make it third and four coming up.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
From the gun on third down, Hayes. A bullet throw, but incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game, because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Been a bit of a dogfight thus far into the second quarter now, and we do have our first point. It's a field goal.
Yeah, a lot of people say, wow, first action on the scoreboard, about time. To me, the action's been right there on the field, trying to figure out who could gain an advantage, gain some field position, finally get points on the board. I'm loving this kind of game.
And feels like kickers might play a big role in this one.
Yes, make sure you give them the respect they deserve. They could cost you a game or win you one. Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Geis with a carry on second down. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. That close on third down, I think everybody probably expecting a run. Instead, they go to the air on third and short yardage.
I realize this is a passing league, and they're liable to throw the ball on any down and distance. But that short, I do question the call. Run the football and pick it up.
Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
The coach.
Sorry, we get slap happy up here sometimes.
56, Mike, 56, right there.
To throw on second down, Hayes. And he will find his man on the outside. Hayes pass. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Looking to throw. Hayes. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it's a second down. Looking to throw on second down. Hayes. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9.
Check, lucky.
Operating from the gun, Hayes. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off near the 42. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. Give him 3 on the game there, second and goal.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. The Redskins now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. It'll definitely be a disappointment to come out of this starting position with just 3 points. They need to try to dial something up now, 3rd and 10. The ground, Geis, and Geis is going to be stopped short as he did not get the push he needed. Now a timeout taken, perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the first half. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle, and this one is right through, and that will knock things up here late in the first half. So they're able to make things level just before half and also leave very, very little time on the clock.
And I love the way that you phrased that. Brought a little soccer into it. And that's really apropos considering they just kicked a field goal to tie things up.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot down. Nope. Guaranteed the head coach is like, don't get crazy. Take the knee. Let's get out of here. Tie game. We'll just start all over.
So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring affair, just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, and this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here we go, back to throw. Hayes is going to fire one deep over the... Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked up by Fabian Moreau. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Looking to throw on second down. Allen, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
Well, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
It's taken to the 26. So possession goes over here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. He's picked off at his own 46.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. So after the INT, it's Allen. And this is taken in for a Redskins touchdown. From 10 yards out, and the Redskins have taken the lead. Well, what a quick turnaround there. They get the football. Next play, boom, touchdown.
I've been in a situation before where a turnover occurs. If you're over on the bench with your defensive mate and you talk about what to do on your next series, and all of a sudden you hear sudden change, you've got to get out on the field and defend right away. Not everyone is mentally prepared to go.
Is that what is yelled on the sidelines a lot of times?
That, among other things.
Maybe some words we can't share here.
Yeah, we'll just keep this one PG.
FCC violation.
No doubt.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Just a lone field goal for them so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up first and 10. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. He's picked off near his own 48. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
They'll try to get this running game going with Geis. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. From the gun, it's Allen. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 21. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. Oh, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy. And can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Second and 10. It's caught inside the 25. And he's a long ways into Washington territory before hitting the turf. A big play there for Philly. 47 yards. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. To Johnson again. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It'll be a gain of 4, but it'll bring us now to a 3rd and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Mike Evans, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And we are even at 10 apiece. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Here we go. The Redskins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Mike out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. They had the interception on the last drive, which led to the tying touchdown. So 10-10 the score as they begin first and 10. A nice start to the drive, picking up 12 yards there and a very quick first down. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Geis. And that one goes for about six as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
A 6-yard pickup brings up second and four at the 44-yard line.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
My name is
Now a run with Geis. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards there, good for a Redskin first down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity, usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
And now they'll throw with Allen. Seferian Jenkins has it, and he'll get it down here to the 43. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
And, oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Redskin first down.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Back to the ground game now with Geis. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Here's Allen to throw it. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington! Steven Sims Jr., his first touchdown on the year. And they're able to break the tie and move out in front here in this fourth quarter. So a one-handed grab in the end zone. Nothing much more rewarding than that for a guy catching it.
Not at all. And with what we just saw there, that type of a one-handed catch, what's next? Maybe they go up and almost Velcro with their jersey in the ball. That's about all that's left. That play, simply spectacular.
So a one-handed grab in the end zone, not much more impressive than that. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded at the 2. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view. than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Second and eight at the 26-yard line.
Right there, 56.
All day, just like that.
To throw on second down. Hayes firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down. On first and 10, Hayes is going to fire one deep. Middle of, and oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. What was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
With the Eagles.
That's right. He's then against with the Eagles, and I believe it's against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. And the drive begins with a run by Geis. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They stay on the ground. Geis again. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. That'll go as a loss of 9, and it leads to third down.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner, and there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game, possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Go, go.
Here we go. On play action, Allen. And that is incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. And the punt over the side in the air. And the spot will be inside the 35. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that
And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Around the 37, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. And give him now four interceptions in this game. That's only the third time this has been done since the year 2000.
I think that tells you how much better teams have gotten at throwing the football. Because if you go all the way back to 1960, 12 times before that, there have been guys who have gotten four interceptions or more in a game. I mean, most recently since 2000, Delta O'Neal and D'Angelo Hall.
They start on the ground with Geis. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and 4. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing.
Heavy, what you got? What you got, Heavy? What you got, Heavy? Give me some. Give me some. Here we go.
And Allen is actually going to throw it here. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. Play clock is going to run out here. They're in no hurry to get a playoff. That's going to set them back 5 yards.
You better be ready next time.
Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game as now they've got it third and long.
Check three.
Allen to throw. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
They have the opportunity now. Here's the execution.
Switch.
He'll look to throw. His throw incomplete. He has had a great... game defensively. He's been east-west, north-south, everywhere.
Yeah, and I love how you described that, because to be a great defender, you have to be able to move up and back, sideline to sideline, and he's been fantastic. Reminds me of a young Charles Davis when he was playing Madden.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, wow, I thought you were going on the field, but okay, I see you. On third down, it's Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Montez Sweat in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Back to throw. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
Ready? 60 or
56.
They're not ready for this, man. They're not ready for this. They still playing soccer.
They'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Mike 5-9.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
Go! Check 99! Check 99! Check 13! Check 13!
Fight! On fourth down, Minshew. Now a desperation throw deep. And it's caught! It's a touchdown! With zeros on the clock, and an extra point will send us to OT.
Brandon, we've seen this many times before. They've got the momentum. They just scored. Go for two and end this thing now.
The kick is good, and can you believe this? They win it with zeros on the clock. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
I think teams around the league are...
Oh, and it's intercepted! Picked off, Byron Jones. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. Jones. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I'd say the staff that's up in the booth watching the game, they may want to file that one away. See how fast the free safety closed to make that play? Might want to check into a throw the next time.
On second and 12, Minshew. And this is caught by Evans. And he is down at the 48. A pickup of four that started at 148-yard line and ended at the other.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
And the Redskins have an extra man in the secondary here on third.
Exit. 56 to Mike, boys. 56. Check 56. Here we go again.
Minshew throwing on third down. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it.
And then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Now with the play clock at 4, we're going to get a timeout call. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. A big call here in overtime. They're going for it on fourth down. Out of the gun is Minshew. And he's got his man on the out route. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A gigantic call there in overtime, but it pays off with a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. 2 minutes left in this overtime session and still all tied.
Let's go.
Set. 60 outlaw.
58 right there. It's on field.
Shoot.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
They'll go again to Jones. And he's going to be stopped close to the first down marker at about the Redskins 26.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Now Jones. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. And that carry, probably not so much for yardage, just to get the spot that you want to kick the field goal.
And any yardage you gain there is really kind of gravy, and this just becomes what my old coach used to say, get into position to be in position. And that's what they want, the right spot for their kicker to line up the field goal.
And he got it! The kick is good in overtime. He's able to split the uprights. We were just treated to an absolute dandy in this one. A great finish in overtime with a long field goal. Everybody, including us, on the edge of their seats. Quite a game.
And it's rare that you get a game into overtime that it doesn't turn out to be a dandy, right? That's what we saw here. And just what you were talking about, a long field goal to win it. So definitely not a gimme. So there was tension all the way through until the ball went through the post.
But it did go through the post. Ice water was in his veins. So for the Eagles, they're on a nice early roll as they move to 3-1 with a win here. And they'll get another road test next week as they have to go to Santa Clara to take on the 49ers. Meanwhile, for Washington, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they'll try to get back on track next week as they head to Dallas to take on the Cowboys. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.